Welcome back to The Rewind, man. It's your man, Landon Lavarius, and we're doing a real special Thanksgiving episode here on The Rewind. We're going to be telling you what you should be binge-watching at the same time while you binge-eating, while you're eating your greens, beans, tomatoes, and your patty pies.
And yo, we're going to do a rewind on John Legend's new legendary Christmas. Something for the holidays right here on The Rewind.
Franchise, what's happening, man?
What's good? The bully's in the building, baby.
Oh, man, it's the Thanksgiving episode, man. We're going to do things a little bit different. Everybody's out there binge eating, right? So now you got to figure out what you're going to binge watch.
Okay.
And I'm going to go with the Netflix original Orange is the New Black. That's what I think everybody should be binging on this Thanksgiving holiday. You need to catch up. Season 6 is already out. You got to go check that out. Season 7 is going to drop next year, and that's going to be the final season. It's going to be too late if you don't catch up now, man. It stars Piper, who's a finance analyst, and she gets caught up in some drug trade thing that happened with her ex-girlfriend. That in itself is a storyline, and she ends up in the same prison as her.
Hey, yo, winter is coming. You gotta bundle up, kid, because, yo, I'm bringing in the storm with the Game of Thrones. I need to see a head come off. I need to see some dragons flying.
Why you want all that for 10?
I need some fire.
Orange is the new
How are you supposed to cook the turkey if we don't got no fire? You talking about Orange is the New Black?
Yeah.
I'm black, and I ain't down with the orange.
Game of Thrones has too much old English in it. I'm not appreciating old English.
It makes you speak proper.
And no, it reminds me of 10th grade Lit, and 10th grade Lit was kicking my ass the whole time. It put me back to a bad place. I don't want to see dragons. I don't want to see that fantasy land. Orange is the New Black is a real story. It's something that really happened to somebody. So that in itself...
You can't fight with Game of Thrones for the simple fact we need a little mystery. We need a little Dungeons and Dragons. Check this out. You got many families fighting for this one crown, this one throne, the Iron Throne.
You want to go see dragons, fire breathing,
listen,
the King's Templar.
Shame.
You done?
No. Okay. So getting back to this whole story, not only is this show hot, but Peter Dinklage is the man. He brings the pain, he brings the cleverness, he brings the wittiness. He's that dude that's sneaking behind the snake in the grass like, yo, move out, snake. I'm about to take your position. And not only take your position, I might weasel my way into this throne business, baby.
You get all that with Orange is the New Black. Everything you just mentioned, you get all that with Orange is the New Black. You got people going for the throne. It's a porcelain throne, but people are going for it. Okay. You got dragons. You got the girl with the dragon tattoo on. There. Only dragon I want to see is Cisco. It's Thanksgiving. You're around family. Let's think about those that can't be around their family. These women are locked up. They have to become each other's family. So they have to come together, and that's something that's for the Thanksgiving holidays. All right, man. Since this episode is just we telling people what to watch,
we're
going to rate each other's shows.
Okay.
So you can do Orange is the New Black. I'm going to do Game of Thrones.
Okay. What you give it?
If I'm going to rate Game of Thrones, I'm going to give it a 3. Because it's dragons and dungeons. Nobody wants to see fallacy. See something that's real, man. Get your beans, greens, potatoes, and warm up your patty pie. Don't watch Game of Thrones, though.
I gave this a solid 4. This show sucks. Why is it that always in this prison, the one that gets hurt the worst is the black person?
Ooh.
She's on trial, but all of them are sipping martinis and ice and whatever. Listen. Go check it out, man. Don't let me bore you, man, but really go check out Game of Thrones. I'm just making my man happy for the holidays. Hey, yo, you know what it is, man? We going in, man. Special day. Yo, your boy, Mr. Legend, not my boy.
I love John Legend,
Mr. Crooner. He's in the building.
Shout out to Chrissy, too.
Learn to Croon. Yes, he has a Christmas legendary album.
Hell yeah.
And guess what? I gotta give respect because Raphael Sadiq, he produced this album. And not only did Raphael Sadiq produce this album, but guess what? We got one of the sickest R&B, soul, rhythm, and blues dudes on this album, Stevie Wonder, baby.
Oh, man, Stevie Wonder came from nowhere.
Just make it, yeah. But check it out. What do you think about this? I heard a couple of songs already.
I love the album. You got a feature from Stevie Wonder on there, so that in itself got to make it legendary with John Legend. I didn't even think Stevie Wonder performed in the studio. I thought he only did funerals nowadays. So it was good to hear him on there. It was good to get a new voice for Christmas. It's like every year, I'm listening to Boyz II Men, Mariah Carey, Temptations. It's like the same song, but John Legend kicked me with a new album, and it pairs, and I really want to listen to it. It's something it's Christmas time, man. Maybe they'll play it in Target or something like that.
That's
something
why
different.
I'm not gonna tear him a new hide so soon. Cause I'm not a John Legend fan.
He's one
of those dudes you can stick up in a boat somewhere and he'll play a little show.
He's real talented. The man plays.
Listen, the dude makes me snore.
How?
He's boring. Come on, but you know what? I ain't gonna ruin your Christmas. It's something special. Go cop this, man. It's a little good shakeup.
Man, you got Rafael Sadiq on it. He's his EP in it, man. And that's a legendary artist in itself. Anytime he's on anything, it's a great album. You never really even heard him have a bad any song or nothing, man.
But anyway, check this out. If you want rocks for Christmas, you're more than welcome to it. But check this out. I give this a solid 5 just because it's Christmas. I ain't a John Legend fan. In fact, I'm a John Legend hater.
Man, what a tough rating. I gotta totally disagree. I'm gonna give this album an 8, A Legendary Christmas by John Legend. It's something new to listen to on Christmas, not the same old, and you get John Legend's voice. And while you get John Legend's voice, you get to think about Chrissy Teigen. You're like, man, his wife is fine. And can I say that? And man, that's gonna be it for us here on The Rewind. As always, you can check us out on globalgrind.com, hashtag The Rewind, to figure out what me and my man Franchise got going on Turkey Day. This the Turkey Day. What you thankful for, Franchise?
I'm thankful for being here, man. That's what I'm thankful for. I'm thankful because I'm on The Rewind with my man. Happy Thanksgiving, my dude.
Thanksgiving, my friend. I'm thankful for everybody that helps shoot The Rewind, that does everything here, family, friends, anybody that's watched us, commented, whether good or bad, I appreciate all the love and hate.
There you go.